Welcome to this tutorial about GRAMM GRAL, a free software package including GRAMM, a prognostic mesoscale wind field model, GRAL, a Lagrangian dispersion model, and a graphical user interface. Welcome to episode 2 of the GRAMM GRAL tutorial. My name is Markus and I will create a simple meteorological time series as used in episode 1 and analyze the meteorological dataset. Meteorological files are simple text files with a file extension .met. If you use measurement data, they should have a time span of 1 year. In the standard .met format, the entries are separated by a comma. In the first column, there's the date, the second column, the time, the third column, the wind speed in meters per second, and the fourth column, the wind direction, and in the last column, the stability class. Now I will create those .met file used in the first episode of the GRAL tutorial. This .met file consists of 24 hours and has a time span of 1 day only. In the first column, I enter the date. I use the 1st of January of 2017. In the second step, I create a time series of 24 hours in the second column. We don't need information about seconds, therefore I change the time format. In the next step, I enter the wind velocity in the third column. I am using the German version of LibreOffice, therefore I have to change the number format to an English language using the dot as a decimal separator. And last but not least, I define the wind direction and a stability class for each hour of our short time series. And finally, I will export the data as CSV file using the comma as separator. In the next step, we can open the graphical user interface and load the created metadata. As we see, the metadata has a time span of 1 day only, and there's a little preview in this window. Now it's possible to check the wind rows, and it's possible to scale or to zoom in that rows or to copy that picture to the clipboard. At the top of this dialog, there's the statistic of the wind rows that can be copied using Ctrl C keys on your keyboard. Now I will load measurement data with a time span of 1 year. Well, after I loaded that, I can display the wind rows as we saw it before. And it's possible to display the wind rows for the stability classes too. By selecting a time span in this dialog, the wind rows will be displayed for this time only. Well, there are several options like the diurnal mean wind velocity or the diurnal frequencies for several wind directions. Well, that's the end of this tutorial. In the next episode, we will add a building to our project and compute the dispersion with buildings. Goodbye!